Can I start? Okay. Morning, everyone. I'm Kim McGuire. I'm the assistant superintendent here at Radnor, and welcome to our first community information session. Thank you for coming. As you probably know, we sent out a survey to find out from the community which topics would be of most interest. And elementary literacy was at the top of the list, tied actually with a couple of other subjects which we plan to tackle as the months go on. So this is an experiment. It will be podcast. It's going to be recorded via podcast, video, and notes, all three of which will be posted on our website, and so that you can see it, relive the magic on demand anytime you want. And I just want to be sure that everyone here or anyone who listens knows that we do have an email that's set up especially to take questions for these sessions. And it is infosessions@rstd.org. And we did get a few questions through that email. But when I say a few, I think like two. So feel free to use the email. The format this morning will be that first, Dr. McGuigan, who is in charge of our literacy program, will be answering the questions that came in, giving an overview of elementary literacy. After that, we expect there will be about a half hour to take your questions. And we encourage you to take a pink index card and a pencil so you can record your questions as Dr. McGuigan speaks. This is especially important because this is going to be recorded. And it occurred to us that we may want to know and keep and archive what your questions were today, but without revealing your identity and without having a miking problem where you'd actually have to come up. So for questions that are formally about the program, we'd like you to put those on index cards, and I'll be sorting them, or one of us will sort them as the discussion goes on. We're also thinking that if things occur to you during the session that you'd like us to add to sessions, have a session on, that you'd let us know that as well. So I don't want to delay the presentation any longer, but I would like to give special thanks to Sandhya Tagabi, who has given us the community perspective and considerable energy and expertise to help us organize the design of this. So now I'd like to introduce Dr. Maureen McGuigan.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Dr. McGuire said, my name is Maureen McGuigan, and I'm the literacy coordinator in Radnor. So I primarily focus on everything that's regarding reading, writing, listening, and speaking from kindergarten through eighth grade, and then partner with Dr. McGuire to work on some things at the high school as well. What we're going to be talking about today is elementary language arts, and as you see, I have brought just about every piece of material that your student might encounter in one of our elementary schools, and I encourage you to remain after the session and take a look at some of the specific materials and have your individual questions answered. I'll do the best I can to address some of the questions that were sent in ahead of time and to give you a broad enough perspective so that regardless of whether your child's in kindergarten or in fifth grade, you'll be able to get something from today's session. But like I said, I really encourage you to stay. I've brought things that teachers use instructionally. I've brought some assessment materials, some materials from special ed, some materials from gifted, independent reading materials, and everything we have to do with our new reading and writing and vocabulary program. Okay, so let's go ahead and get started. I did give you a few handouts as you came in the door. There were two pieces. The blue handout is stapled together, and we'll refer to a couple of these things as we move through our work today. And then I also provided you with, this is actually a couple years old, from our word study program. And this little brochure outlines the word study curriculum from kindergarten through eighth grade. So you can look in there and identify where your student might be encountering activities in word study. Also on the Radnor Township School District website, this is the link where any of the parent handouts that you see today can be accessed. You don't need a logon or security or anything like that. You can go right onto the page and take a look at everything that you see today electronically. All right, what we're going to look at today, we're going to start out with our elementary language arts core materials first, because that would be the piece that's probably of the widest interest to everyone. Making Meaning is our core comprehension program. We have our Making Meaning vocabulary program. We'll take a look at the new writing program, which is called Being a Writer. And then we'll talk about the pieces that partner with the core materials, which include independent daily reading. You might hear your children referring to it as IDR, which is what the teachers usually call it. Guided reading, which has been around for a long time, but has taken a new role with our new program. And also word study, which I talked about in the brochure. We'll take a look at assessment and the assessment tools that the teachers use, how students are assessed to ensure that they're making progress in the language arts program, how frequently they're assessed, and how that information is communicated. And then we're going to look a little bit at some of the supplemental and alternate materials, things that are used in special ed, junior grade books, and I have a little bit for you on home connection and things that you can be doing at home. As far as what's new in our program and what's not new, as I said, new this year, we have Making Meaning, which includes independent daily reading, the Making Meaning vocabulary, and Being a Writer. Continued this year from before, we still are doing our word study program from about 4 years ago. We're in our fourth year now. Students still have an opportunity for guided reading in the classroom at the elementary level. And yes, we do still teach handwriting. We'll talk a little bit about that today as well, because that's a topic that often comes up. Here's a chart that gives you a snapshot of what happens in our elementary schools by grade level. And the teachers refer to this as the who teaches what chart. At which grade levels will students be exposed to which program? And you'll see that for the most part, everyone from kindergarten to fifth grade does about the same thing. Which was really our goal this year, was to make sure that we were standardizing things so that children heard common language from grade level to grade level, and they could build on their learning from the year before instead of starting something new with new routines and new learning structures. Our kindergartners this year are using the Making Meaning program. They haven't started the vocabulary program yet. They're going to be taking a look at that next year. But because of the half-day format with kindergarten, we weren't quite sure if that was going to fit in for them. But the Making Meaning seems to be fitting in very well. They are doing Being a Writer. They do word study with the Foundations program, which we'll look at. They do guided reading, independent daily reading, and of course they have handwriting in kindergarten. Our first graders have all the core programs, just like the other grades, the word study, guided reading, IDR, and handwriting. What you'll see that starts to differ is when you get down to third grade, our third graders have some supplemental writing units. Although we were very happy with the writing program, we felt that we wanted to ramp it up a bit for our population, and you'll see that third grade also spends some extra time doing a unit on how to write for test taking, like writing on demand, which is different from doing the type of creative writing and process writing that they do. And they also do a unit on poetry to make sure that we have a grade level where poetry is specifically emphasized. In all the writing programs and all the Making Meaning programs, but here the students will do a more in-depth study. And when we get to fourth grade, they again look at the writing for test preparation, and they have a focus unit on persuasive writing. And when we get to fifth grade has a focus on what they call functional writing, which is what we would refer to as research or a research paper or something like that. Different types of writing you would do in science and social studies, but they put that under the umbrella of functional writing. All right, so let's start with our Making Meaning. The students have a program that's called Making Meaning. Although it's the core of the language arts program in the area of comprehension, the lessons themselves actually are designed to take up only a very small portion of the language arts block. Beginning in kindergarten, the lessons are 10 to 15 minutes long. As we get up to fourth and fifth grade, some of them can be as long as 30 or 40 minutes. They don't occur every day. Kindergarten has it twice a week. When you get to fifth grade, they have it 4 days a week. There's never an expectation that the lesson will occur 5 days a week because the focus is on application. But it's direct instruction in tiered comprehension skills using a common language. So from grade level to grade level to grade level, all the comprehension strategies have the same names. all the cooperative structures have the same names. The instructional format remains the same. So when students next year come from kindergarten to first grade, they're already going to know how to turn and talk to their partner. They're already going to have exposure to some of the strategies. There are 9 different strategies that they focus on, and the lessons are driven by an anchor text that the teacher uses to model behaviors. So the designers of the program used a committee of folks to select trade books that they felt lent themselves to the different topics regarding the comprehension strategies and the various topics addressed in the writing program. They had people like Jim Trelease, who wrote the Read Aloud Handbook, and people like that help them to select the books. And when they were delivered to the teachers, that's always the first thing that you hear from the teachers. Oh, I love the literature. I love this book. I love that book. Every book that they pick out of the box, they're very excited about. Lots and lots of diversity, fiction, nonfiction, big books. A teacher, I was in a classroom the other day, and a teacher was reading a little teeny tiny Beatrix Potter book. And I'm like, who would have ever picked that book to read to 25 students because it was so small? But it was perfect for the strategy being taught, and then the teacher went to the library and brought back a whole basket of Beatrix Potter, which is something that students today don't always get a chance to see. But lots and lots of diversity, balance of male and female protagonists, a variety of cultures represented, so they do a really good job on the text selection. The cooperative structures are designed to give students an opportunity to hear different perspectives and to process what they've learned. We know from research that students need 3 times as much time to process the learning as they need for the particular instruction. So if you teach a student something new for 10 minutes, they really should have 30 minutes of time to have conversations and apply that learning so that they can create it as their own. This is one of the bulletin boards that I saw the other day. I was in a 4th grade classroom. And what they do in their classroom is they have each of their strategies posted, rereading, questioning and wondering. And as they read an anchor text, the teacher posts it on the bulletin board next to the name of the strategy. So if a student needs a little bit of support applying a strategy or isn't quite sure what the strategy involves, she can say, oh, well, remember when we read Ms. Nelson is back and we talked about rereading the text. So the student always has a place they can refer to. Even going on to the next year, the 5th grade teacher will know that when 4th grade worked on rereading, they read Gloria and they read Ms. Nelson. So she has that piece to draw on. The piece related to making meaning that is most important is what we call the individualized daily reading. Students are expected to spend time every day reading in an independent reading book. The book is to be an instructional match for them, and built within the program is an expectation that they're going to build their stamina. So as the teacher works through making meaning, they'll read in kindergarten. Students should have time today to read independently for 5 minutes. Students should have time to read independently today for 10 minutes. And each grade level has a goal. So at the end of kindergarten, the hope is that students can read independently and focused for 15 minutes uninterrupted. And this is just one of the studies I put up for you. One of the most extensive studies of independent reading yet conducted, researchers investigated a broad array of activities and their relationship to reading achievement and growth in reading. They found that the amount of time students spent in independent reading was the best predictor of reading achievement and also the best predictor of the amount of gains in reading achievement made by students between 2nd and 5th grade. So again, that time to apply. I read Ms. Nelson and I talk about various strategies, and at the end of the lesson, the teacher will say to the students, today in your independent reading book, you're going to look for ways the character is developing, or you're going to look for ways the character is solving a problem. Something directly related to exactly what was taught in the lesson. So the students are applying what's taught, and they're looking for texts that they find interesting and are a match to their independent reading levels. And we're going to talk a little bit about parts of that that have presented a challenge and how we've tried to address some of those concerns. It really is the cornerstone of the literacy program. When we first started our training at the beginning of the year, you know, teachers would say, oh, you know, it's new to me, and the lesson, instead of taking 10 minutes, it took 30 minutes. So, you know, the students were still learning the cooperative structures, and maybe lots of people asked questions. So I skipped the independent reading. And that is really through our conversations and our discussion and our training. That's absolutely something that we don't want to do. We absolutely don't want to have that happen. If a lesson takes longer on Monday and the independent reading time is opted out, then that time is added on to the next day or put into a different time of day. The important thing is that the students learn each strategy they're able to get to and that they have time to apply it, not that they're just introduced to all the strategies. We're really going for the depth with this program. And this is just a comment about the, because this year it's very new, I think, to see students doing so much independent reading. And sometimes in the past, you know, past years or even decades ago, there was talk about, you know, deer time, drop everything and read, SSR, people had different acronyms and whatnot. You know, if you finish your work early, take out a book and read. All right, this is a really focused reading time. The students are given a specific task based on their lesson to apply to their independent reading. And then the teachers have had explicit training in how to support independent reading. And this is one of their support kits that they use. And they had various books that they used to practice conferring with students. And then it also provides them with a data collection system that they can use so that when they have conversations with students, they're collecting specific data that's related to the student's individual goals and the goals of the lesson. So at the end of the year, I can pull out my little IDR sheets and I can say, when I was conferring with Billy at the beginning of the year, we were talking about characterization at this level. And now that we're at the end of the year, we're talking about it at this level. So it's much more focused than what you would think of as a SSR or like a free time reading. Students are accountable to the application of the learning through the individual conferring with teachers. All right, now here's an example of the systems that we've been putting in place this year to make sure students have books that are available to them that are both at their instructional level and are of interest to them. Most teachers have fairly full classroom libraries, but we started last year with them, giving them time to make sure that they were able to level them. So if you look at this fourth grade library, you'll see that the teacher has level Q, and you go right behind the level Q and you'll see a variety of books that are level Q. With the amount of independent reading that the students need to use in this program, there were nowhere near enough books in individual classroom libraries for everyone to find a book at their level and of interest. I mean, even here you can see level Q. If I'm a level Q, I'm not going to be reading these 15 books for the entire year if I'm spending, you know, 40 or 50 minutes a day reading. So one of the things we've done this year is we moved into a book basket system where books are leveled based on a coloring system, but of course it's also correlated to our letter system that students are familiar with. So a teacher can go to the library and they can borrow various baskets to put in their room. And each, these are smaller, but each basket contains 30 books. So the bronze baskets are instructional reading levels of 7 and 8. And actually, because bronze books are bigger, it comes in two baskets. So a teacher can borrow 30 books at the 8th grade level to put in her classroom. They can borrow 30 books at the 7th grade level to put in their classroom. 30 books at the 6th grade level to put in their classroom. 90 books in their classroom at three different levels. And then if after 2 weeks or 3 weeks they find that, you know, the students have selected the books of interest and they've read them, they're finished with them, they can take them back to the library, they can return them, and they can get three new baskets. So that way, without trying to replenish individual libraries across the district, we can always add new baskets, we can always bring in new books, things can always be current, and everyone can have easy access to all the materials. So these are available in the libraries, but only for the teachers to check out. So the teacher checks these out as a big basket, and I know they looked really appealing when the kids saw it. I know at Radnor Elementary, they're all lined up on the shelves, actually out in the library, and the kids are like, "Ooh, wow, look, big colored baskets of books." But they are borrowed by the teachers, and they're not for loan to individual students. But these are from the American Reading Company, which is actually in King of Prussia. And they do the 100 book challenge. Some districts do the 100 book challenge where everybody tries to read 100 books. And this is the system they use to provide schools that are doing the 100 book challenge with a variety of literature without having to, again, purchase libraries for everyone. And it, again, it's really nice because all the books have been reviewed. We needed to buy 7th and 8th grade books for our 5th graders, and that can sometimes be a very difficult thing to do because the topics are too sophisticated. And they actually, at the 7th and 8th grade level, have three collections. They have what they call their rated G collection, that's, you know, clean language and clean concepts and all of that. And then they have their sophomore collection, which could be a little more risque. And then they have their standard collection, which is really for 8th graders. But they do a nice job of mixing fiction and nonfiction. You'll see that it's not just novels, that there are a variety of books. They have comic books. They have all kinds of things regarding current issues and topics that students of that grade level would be interested in. So we purchased, I think we have about 40 baskets for each building right now. They're not spread out evenly from kindergarten to fifth grade because we had certain grade levels that had a lot of, that had more need than other grade levels. One area was kindergarten. We needed books that were pre-kindergartners, some of the wordless books and things like that, so we got a lot of kindergarten books. Our kindergarten classrooms, for some reason also, are very well stocked with nonfiction. I think, I don't know if PTO bought them books a while ago or what it was, but when we did an inventory last year, we're like, wow, you have enough nonfiction for a long time. So we focused on some fiction pieces for kindergarten, and then the other area where we focused were our high flyers in 4th and 5th grade that really needed independent reading materials, again, that were at the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade levels. So hopefully we're going to be able to continue to add to those each year. First of all, to make more baskets available to more teachers, and second of all, to make sure that there's current literature threaded through it, and it evolves each year so kids can see something new. All right, the next piece we're going to talk about, which hasn't gotten a whole lot of attention, but as we were out in the buildings last week, another district came to visit Radnor and look at the Making Meaning and Being a Writer program. The teachers are so excited about the vocabulary piece. Making Meaning has a supplemental vocabulary unit, and this is a sample of what you might see in your child's classroom. As I said, we don't have it in kindergarten yet. They'll have it next year. In first grade, you'll see it with pictures. You see the vocabulary words, and then you also see a picture that depicts the meaning of the word. But Making Meaning has a vocabulary